Good morning, students. This is your science teacher, Meetu, and today we are going to study the topic reproduction in animals, or in Hindi, Jantuo mein Janan, from your class 8 science textbook. So, what are the things which we are going to study? Let us see.
Reproduction in animals. In this lesson, we will talk about sexual and asexual reproduction, external and internal fertilization, viviparous and oviparous animals, and the different kinds of asexual reproduction like budding in Hydra and binary fission in amoeba.
So students, today we'll be talking about reproduction. Reproduction. Now, as you all know, students, there are various important life processes. For example, like respiration, the intake of food, digestion, the excretion, the growing, the metabolism, everything. So, when you know that all these important life processes are essential for survival of an individual, as we all know that the living beings, they do certain things for their existence. But today we are talking about reproduction. So, just I want you to have a thought that reproduction is also the life process, one among the life process. So, without eating, can a living being survive? No. Without respiration, can a living being survive? No. Without excretion, can a living being survive? No. But can you tell me that without reproduction, can a living being survive? Yes, students, without reproduction also, a living being can survive. We have seen so many couples, they don't have their children, but still they are surviving. So, reproduction, maybe it is not the important life process which is essential for maybe survival, but still reproduction is very important. Let me tell you that in your class 8, reproduction they have given you in a big chapter, a chapter called reproduction. So if it has been created in a single chapter, that means it has a very important role in survival of the human beings or maybe the living organisms. So we'll talk about that, why reproduction is so important. So first of all, we'll see what is reproduction. Reproduction is a process by which a new organism of the same species are formed from the existing species. Okay, this is reproduction. Now, let me tell you why this reproduction is so important. Students, reproduction is very important for maintaining the continuity of species in this earth, on this earth. Students, just think. Just go back, you know, maybe 1,000 years back, if, you know, there were no reproduction process, what could have been happened? The organisms which has been formed in those days, after death, it could have been extinct, you know. We won't be able to see those organisms. Like, you know, for example, human beings, we have been formed so many thousands of years back. Still, human being is existed on this species. Likewise, so many animals, so many plants. So, reproduction is a process, reproduction is a phenomena which helps the continuity of the species on this earth. Now, in the reproduction process, the young ones, they replace the old dying individuals.
Reproduction. Reproduction is a process by which new individuals of same species are produced by existing organisms. It is essential for maintaining of continuity of species on Earth. The young ones replace the old dying individuals.
So we have seen the importance of reproduction. Now we'll talk about the modes of reproduction. Modes of reproduction. So modes, or you can say types of reproduction also. Types of reproduction. So students, there are two types or two modes of reproduction. Number one is the sexual reproduction. And number two is the asexual reproduction. So let me explain you first what is sexual reproduction. In sexual reproduction, two parents participate to form a new organism with the involvement of the gametes, by making use of the gametes. Now, what is gametes? For example, the male sperm is the male gamete and the ovum or the egg is the female gametes. So, a process of reproduction in which I told you two parents will participate and a new individual will be formed by making use of the gametes. That is known as sexual reproduction. Keep that in mind. Two parents has to be there. Two parents has to participate. Next is the asexual reproduction. Now, in the asexual reproduction, the new organism is formed with the participation of only single parent and without the involvement of the gametes. Okay, and this asexual reproduction, it takes place in all the unicellular organisms and few multicellular organisms, for example sponges and the hydra. Okay, so this is the asexual reproduction.
Modes of reproduction or types of reproduction. First, sexual reproduction. It is a process of reproduction of a new organism from two parents by making use of sperm and ovum, that is the gametes, example, or multicellular organisms. Asexual reproduction, the production of new organism from single parent without the involvement of gametes. For example, all unicellular organisms and some multicellular organisms like sponges and hydra.
So we have seen the two types of reproduction, that is the sexual and asexual reproduction. Now first we'll talk about the sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction. We'll see here the sexual reproduction in human beings. Students, as I've already told you, in sexual reproduction, there is the involvement of the gametes. Now, first of all, we'll talk about the human sperm. The human sperm. As you know, it is the male gamete. So, now, what is human sperm? Human sperm is a single cell. Number one, it is the male gamete. It is produced from the pair of testes and it has, the body is divided into three parts. Students, the body is divided into three parts. You can see it is divided into three parts. This is the head. This is the head. It is known as the middle piece and this is the tail. So now, as you can see here, the head is pointed and it has a tail also. This, a particular structure of the sperm, it helps in the easy movement in the semen. Okay, so it almost, you know, the head is pointed, it easily penetrate and moves, and the tail, it helps in the constant and easy movement of the sperm.
Sexual reproduction in humans. Human sperm, it is a male gamete, it is a single cell, its body is divided into three major parts, a head, a middle piece and a tail. This slide shows you a figure of human sperm. It is divided into three parts, head, middle piece and a tail. The structure of the head and the tail, it helps in the easy movement of the sperm in the semen.
Now students, we'll talk about human ovum or the egg cell. Human ovum or the egg cell. Human ovum, it is the female gamete. It is a single cell and it is produced from the ovaries.
Human ovum or egg. It is a female gamete. It is produced from the ovaries. It is a single cell. This slide shows you a figure of human ovum.
Now students, we have already seen the two gametes, the male gamete and the female gamete. Now we'll talk about the fertilization. Fertilization. What is fertilization? Students, the fusion of male gamete, that is the sperm, with the female gamete, that is the ovum, is known as the process of fertilization. When the sperm comes in contact with the egg, they fuses together and the two nuclei from the male and the female gamete, it fuses to become a single nucleus and it forms a zygote. This zygote is the fertilized egg, and zygote is the beginning of every new individual. This zygote consists of, as I told you, the nuclei from the sperm and the ovum, and these two nuclei fuses to become a single nuclei. That is why, students, the newborn child, it inherits or it consists the characteristic of both from the father and the mother.
Fertilization, the process of fusion of male gamete or sperm with female gamete or ovum is called fertilization. During fertilization, the nuclei of sperm and the egg fuses to form a single nucleus. This slide shows you a figure of fertilization of sperms and ovum. You can see the sperms comes in contact with the ovum and fuses with it. Hence, the fertilization process takes place. Formation of zygote. It is formed as a result of fusion of sperm and ovum. It is the fertilized egg. Zygote is the beginning of new individual. It consists of the nuclei from both parents. The two nuclei fused and become one nucleus. Hence, a child born inherits the characteristics of both father and mother. This slide shows the fusion of human egg cell and human sperm cell. When the egg cell fuses with the sperm cell, fertilization takes place and zygote forms. This slide shows human zygote. The human zygote consists of two nuclei which fuses to form single nucleus.
Students, we have seen fertilization. Now, let me tell you that there are two types of fertilization. Fertilization, two types. First is the internal fertilization. Internal fertilization, and second is the external fertilization. External fertilization. Now, first we'll see what is internal fertilization. Students, the process of fertilization which takes place inside the female body is known as internal fertilization. For example, human beings, the cows, the cats, the dogs, those are the animals which shows the internal fertilization. Now, the external fertilization. The fertilization which takes place outside the female body is known as external fertilization. For example, in frogs, in fishes, etc. In these animals, the fertilization takes place outside the female's body. Now, the external fertilization, mostly it takes place in water. For example, in frogs, when a female frog, it lays its eggs in the water, the male frog comes and it releases its sperms. Now, when the sperms comes in contact with the eggs, the fertilization takes place outside the female body, and hence it is known as external fertilization.
There are two types of fertilization. First, internal fertilization. Fertilization which takes place inside the female body is called internal fertilization. Example, humans, cows, dogs, hens, etc. These two animals undergo the process of internal fertilization. External fertilization. Fertilization which takes place outside the female body. For example, frogs, fishes, etc. In these animals, fertilization takes place in water. When the female lays eggs in water, the male comes and releases its sperms and fertilization takes place. This is the external fertilization in fishes. When the female fish lays eggs in the water, the male fish comes and releases its sperms and the sperms fuses with the eggs and external fertilization takes place outside the female body.
Now students, the process of fertilization over. Now we'll talk about the development of the embryo. Development of embryo. Students, in development of embryo, let us see that, as you know, fertilization results in the formation of zygote. Fertilization results in the formation of zygote. This zygote, further, it develops into an embryo. It develops into an embryo. Okay, then this zygote, it divides continuously to form a ball of cells, to form a mass of cells. Now, these cells further, it develops into various tissues and then organs of the body. And the developing stage, that particular developing stage is known as embryo. And this embryo, it develops in the uterus or the womb of the mother. Now listen very carefully. The stage of embryo with all the identified body parts is known as fetus. Is known as fetus. This fetus, it tends to develop in the uterus of the mother.
Development of embryo. Fertilization results in the formation of zygote, which begins to develop into an embryo. The zygote divides repeatedly to give rise to a ball of cells. The cells then begin to form different tissues and organs of the body. This developing structure is known as embryo. Embryo develops in uterus. The embryo with all identified body parts is called fetus. This slide shows you the development of embryo from zygote. First stage is the formation of zygote. Then the two cells divide into four cells. The four cells then further divide into eight cells. Eight cells further divide into 16 cells, thereby forming a ball of cells. This slide shows you the development of embryo. The first stage is the fusion of male and female gametes, thereby forming a zygote. The zygote repeatedly divides to form a ball of cells. The cells divides to form various tissues and organs of the body. This stage is known as the embryo. The embryo develops in the uterus of the mother. The embryo with all the identified body parts is known as fetus. Finally, the fetus developed in the womb or the uterus of the mother. This slide shows you the developed fetus in mother's uterus.
Now students, we have seen how the embryo, it develops from a zygote and then it becomes a fetus. And now we'll talk about the difference between viviparous animals and oviparous animals. First is the viviparous and second is the oviparous. So now first we'll see what is viviparous animals. Students, those animals which give birth to their young ones is known as viviparous animals. For example, human beings, the cows, the dogs, the cats, they give birth to their young ones. Hence, they are known as viviparous animals. Second is the oviparous animals. They are those animals which lay eggs. So, the animals which lays their egg is known as oviparous animals. For example, you know, hens, the crocodiles, the lizards, etc. They are oviparous animals which lay eggs.
Difference between viviparous animals and oviparous animals. The animals which give birth to their young ones are called viviparous animals. For example, human beings, dogs, cows, etc. Oviparous animals. Those animals which lay eggs are called oviparous animals. For example, hens, crocodiles, lizards, etc. This slide shows you the oviparous animals which lays eggs and the viviparous animals which give birth to their babies.
Now students, we'll talk about what is metamorphosis. Metamorphosis is a process by which the transformation of larva to adult through a drastic changes is known as metamorphosis. For example, you will see this in, you know, the life cycle of frogs. You know, the adult frog, it lays eggs and it develops into a tadpole or known as the larva. And from the larva to the adult stage, it has undergone several drastic changes. You know, the larva or the tadpole of a frog, it almost looks like a fish. You know, it has a tail, it swims in the water. But after few weeks, that small larva, it develops its limbs, which means legs, the forelimb, the hind limb and forelimb and the hind limb. And it has a tail also. Gradually, the tail disappears and a small frog is formed. And finally, that small frog converted into an adult frog. So this drastic changes, you know, students, from the larval stage to the adult stage is known as metamorphosis.
Metamorphosis, the transformation of the larva into an adult through drastic changes is called metamorphosis. For example, frogs, silkworm, etc. This slide shows you the life cycle of frog. You can see the drastic change from the tadpole or the larva of a frog into an adult. Here you can see the adult frog, it lays a mass of eggs. When the male comes in contact and releases its sperm, the eggs fertilized and fertilization takes place. Then the tadpole forms. The tadpole or the larva, it almost looks like a small fishes. Then the tadpole, it starts to develop legs. Finally, it develops its legs, all the limbs, and gradually the tail disappear and the small young frog develop into an adult frog. So the life cycle of frog shows a drastic change from the tadpole or the larva to an adult frog. This process is known as metamorphosis.
Now students, finally we'll talk about the asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction. Students, there are several methods of asexual reproduction. You will be studying it in the higher class like class 10th. But in this class, you will be studying two types of asexual reproduction. That is, number one is the budding in hydra. And number two is the binary fission in amoeba. Binary fission in amoeba. Students, just listen this very carefully because you got this in your class 10th also. So now first we'll talk about what is budding in hydra. Hydra is a multicellular organism. It has a small buds in its body. For example, you can see this is a hydra and it has a small bulge. See, it is a small bulge in its body. Slowly, this bulge, it develops into a small buds, and this buds, it forms the small hydra, small baby hydra. Okay, see, this bulge, this is a bud. Gradually, this bud develop into a small hydra. After few days, what happens? This hydra, it matures and it gets detached from its parent body and form into a new hydra. See students, this is a hydra. It has a small bulge known as the bud. This bud develop into a individual hydra. After few days, this hydra get detached from its parent body and form a new hydra. See, listen very carefully, as we have already discussed what is asexual reproduction. Here you can see only a single parent, only a single organism is involved in the formation of new organism. From a single hydra, a new hydra is formed. That is why it is known as asexual reproduction. And since this reproduction is due to the formation of buds, it is known as budding, budding in hydra. Now, next we'll see what is binary fission in amoeba. Amoeba is a single cell organism or the unicellular organism. See, this is amoeba. As you know, amoeba is a shapeless organism. This is amoeba. When the amoeba matures, the nucleus starts to divide into two. See, you can see this is the body of the amoeba. The nucleus, it starts to slowly, gradually divide into two nuclei. With the nucleus also, see that the single nucleus, it starts to develop into two nuclei. Gradually, the body also, it divides and, you know, consists of the single nucleus. See, initially the nucleus starts to develop, starts to divide, then the organism divided the two body parts. Each body part contains the single nucleus, and the two grown up daughter amoebae is formed. See, from a single amoeba, you know, it divides and two daughter amoebae is formed. Here also, students, please note one point, that only single organism is involved for the formation of the new organism. So that is why it is also the asexual mode of reproduction. And here, since two daughter amoebae are formed, it is known as binary fission. Students, bi means two. So this is a binary fission in amoeba. So these are the two types of asexual reproduction which you need to study in this class. So students, let us just sum up the lesson. Let's recapitulate the lesson. What we have seen? We have seen the reproduction in animals. We know that reproduction is essential for maintaining the continuity of species in this earth. Then we have seen two modes of reproduction, that is the sexual and asexual reproduction. Then we have seen the fertilization process, the internal fertilization and external fertilization. Then we have also seen the formation of the zygote, then the the development of the embryo. Then we have also talked about the difference between the viviparous and oviparous animals. We have also seen what is metamorphosis. It is a process by which the larva turns into adult through a drastic changes. Then finally, we have seen the two types of asexual reproduction, that is the budding in hydra and, you know, binary fission in amoeba. And I hope that you might have taken the snapshot of the topics, and I believe that you will note down all the important points and you will try to connect the topics, the teachings which I have given you with your textbook, and you will try to study it and know it much more better. And with this hope, I want to take a leave from you. Take care, stay at home and keep on studying.